Hello, I'm Ailsa Williams and I'm a third year Biomedical Sciences student at Teddy Hall and I'm from Frome in Somerset. Biomedical Sciences varies quite a lot across the 3 years. In the first year, there are six main units that you study. These are split into genetics, molecules, brain and behaviour, and cells and body. So for each of these topics you will have tutorials, and for each of the tutorials you'll be set work, normally the essays, but sometimes you're asked to do an annotated diagram, which is a fun way of learning. So at the end of the year you're tested on each of these topics. There's essays on each of the topics as well as some multiple choice questions. As well as all these topics, there's that statistics to learn in first year. I really enjoyed the statistics course and it's an important thing to engage with to help you with your studies later on in the course. Second year is split into two sections. So the first two terms of second year you are doing taught modules. All of these modules you choose yourself, so there's a big range of options, from stuff like psychology options to neuroscience options to immunology options, pharmacology and endocrinology. That's just a brief overview of the kind of different themes you can study. So you have tutorials throughout the first two terms, and then at the beginning of third term you're examined on all this material. This is actually a really good time to have exams because it's before the start of term, so you can just focus on the exams over the holidays and then get it all over and done with in time for third term. And I think third term of second year is absolutely the highlight of the degree. You're based in a lab for the whole term and you just help a lab out with their research. This is such a great way to immerse yourself with research as a concept, and you can learn so much from this opportunity. It's quite a daunting opportunity before it happens, but when you get there you realise that your bosses are just there to help you, because the more they help you, the more you can help them, and that's a good way to be. So after second year, in your second year summer, it's quite common that people do internships, and there's so many amazing opportunities to carry out internships, and I'd really recommend looking into different opportunities. So through the university I got to go to Singapore, and again I was immersed into a lab experience, and I think this is a great way of really getting to understand science and biomedical sciences as a whole, as opposed to just learning the content. So I'd really recommend looking into internships if that is feasible for you after second year. So in third year, you completely have a choice of what you study again. These are more broad topics now, as opposed to smaller topics like in second year, and you can kind of go for themes such as immunology or neuroscience or endocrinology. There's lecture courses on all of these topics, and you can sign up to tutorials as and when you please. This is a great system because it means you are only under as much pressure as you want to be. So as well as all of the taught sections that you are examined on at the end of the year, you also have to write up your second year project. This is a great opportunity as it means you really need to engage with the work that you've done and learn how to write as if you were writing a scientific paper, and makes you really consider how to approach science, including the statistics, which is taught in first year, and it really brings together the whole course that you've learned. And so as well as the exams and your project, there's also a specialist review, which is like a mini dissertation you need to write up, and again is a great way of integrating yourself with the literature and learning a lot about scientific writing. So that's a summary of the course. It's a great way to immerse yourself in the biomedical sciences field, and I'd really recommend applying here if you are interested in these kind of topics. So I think a personal statement is really important as it shows the tutors who you are as a person and what you are interested in. So this means really discussing the books and talks that you've been to that you've really enjoyed, and I think it's important to show that you've kind of gone beyond just reading the books or going to the talks, and doing a bit of extra reading around the subject just on the internet is a great way to make your personal statement stand out. For example, Wikipedia has loads of great information on it. Maybe don't reference Wikipedia in your personal statement, but I know when I was applying I spent quite a lot of time reading on websites such as Wikipedia. Otherwise just really kind of try and show that you've got character and that you're somebody that they would want to teach the subject that you're applying for and that you're passionate about. But just try and be genuine and excited in your personal statement, I would say, is the best way to approach it. So for biomedical sciences, you need to sit the biomedical admissions test, which or the BMAT test. This is kind of a combination of physics, chemistry, and biology questions, as well as a short essay at the end. So to prepare for this, I went over GCSE physics, and you might need to go over GCSE chemistry or biology if you haven't studied them since then. But just kind of familiarising yourself with the basics of these three subjects is important. And also, because I hadn't written for the whole of A levels, I kind of went back and practiced doing some writing again. But I think the best way to approach these exams is to somehow acquire a study book. So you can get them online, I think, or I just got one from an older person who had done the BMAT previously because they don't have a need for the book anymore. So yeah, if you can acquire like a, they've got loads of multiple choice questions in and the essay questions at the back. So if you can just go through one of those books, you'll be more than prepared to sit the test, kind of like doing a past paper for your GCSE exams, that kind of thing. So yeah, they're not too scary. It's kind of a daunting process because it's an extra bit of work to study for, but if you make sure you give yourself enough time and don't try not to get too worked up about it should be all okay. So the interview was a really cool experience. I think firstly you should just make sure that you're proud of yourself for getting that far. It's a cool experience. You get to stay in Oxford colleges overnight, and there's loads of you get loads of food given to you, and I spent a bit of time playing table football in the JCR. So yeah, it's a big achievement, and you should just enjoy the experience whilst you can. The actual interviews themselves, I can't remember too much in detail how they were, but I think ultimately the tutors are just looking for somebody they want to teach. So if they ask you a question and you don't know the answer, that doesn't matter because everybody knows different things and it's come from different backgrounds. So they aren't looking for somebody who knows everybody. They aren't looking for somebody who knows everything. They're just looking for somebody who wants to learn as much as they possibly can. So engaging with what they're asking and asking questions yourself is a far better approach than just making it out like you know everything. So yeah, just relax. And if you can portray your passion for the subject, I'm sure the tutors will be able to see that, and that's all you need to do. But yeah, it's a fun experience, so make sure you enjoy it while you can. So I actually took a year out and applied in my year out in between A levels and going to university, and I think this made a big difference in how I approached my offer. I actually was in Canada working for the summer, so didn't necessarily do that much extra reading or anything, and I think this is fine. I think it's more important to have a break in between. You've worked so hard for your A levels, and I'd say that you're better off kind of doing something to relax and enjoy yourself rather than over preparing because you'll just burn out before term even starts. I did get summer work and I completed that obviously, and it was enjoyable and gives you a taste of what the course is going to be like. But yeah, I'd say taking some time off is more important than hyper stressing about what you're going to be learning next year. Alternatively, if you can get any kind of lab work, that would be amazing. I think any kind of practical knowledge about the subject is the most helpful thing that you can do for biomedical sciences. Teddy Hall is an amazing place to study. Firstly, the library is a very old church, which is just a great place to get to work in. There's stained glass windows everywhere, and you're surrounded by your friends and peers who are also doing the same work as you, and it makes you feel like you're part of a community who's all working to try and improve themselves and learn for their degree, which is amazing. Beyond academia, there's so many extracurricular activities from sports to more arty things. So I was more sporty and took part in the football and the hockey, and these are great and relatively competitive but very inclusive. So definitely if you haven't played these sports before, it's a great thing to get involved with, particularly for girls. The football is my particular favourite sport. On the more arty side of things or music things, there's the choir is great, and they do evening song every Sunday, and is an amazing thing to get involved in. As well as the choir, there's even a Cayley band, which is based quite heavily in Teddy Hall, or lots of people from Teddy Hall are in it, so getting yourself involved with that kind of thing is very feasible from Teddy Hall. Also, plays are often ran by pupils, so yeah, I think there's extracurricular activities for anybody and everybody. So I think the most important thing when applying to BEd on Biomedical Sciences is to express your passion for the subject, but also to not get caught up on the small details. If you know this is what you want to do, I'm sure the tutors will be able to pick that up. So just kind of try and enjoy the experience, try and immerse yourself as much as possible in the things you enjoy studying, find the things that you're passionate about, and I suppose this applies for any subject, just make sure that you're applying for the correct reasons and are going to enjoy it when you're there, because there'd be nothing worse than getting there and not enjoying the subject. So yeah, if you've got any questions, please ask them in the comments below, and follow SEH Access on Instagram for more videos such as this.